Hello, friends, and welcome to Escaping the Mouse with your host, me, Breck Roll. All right, here we go. This is going to be our first episode of Mouse Food. I don't know if I'm going to stick with that. That's kind of just a working title right now. I don't know. Let me know what you think with that, if you have any better ideas. But what I'm trying to do is come up with something clever for this segment, you know, that will be as memorable as...
That's not how it's done.
I don't know if this is it. Maybe not, but... that's where we're going for now. Anyway, I have picked my first recipe. I was actually pleased that within about the first 15 hours of that video going live, I had about 10 people submit things. And the truth is, I looked at everything, and there isn't anything in there that I looked at and said, yeah, no, I'm not doing that. Everything looked really good. I had a couple of you that suggested meatloafs, and I do love meatloafs. So I got two meatloaf recipes we're going to try at some point. I can't do that today, however, because I don't have my meatloaf pan. That's in the storage locker somewhere. I also got something that required a casserole dish, and my casserole dishes are also in the storage locker. So the criteria for what we chose today was obviously the first thing. It has to look really good. Number two, you know, I have to have the kitchen utensils to do it. Three, it had to look relatively easy to do. And number four actually was kind of an added thing because I got told by the doctor yesterday that I need to kind of, you know, watch my blood pressure a little bit. And this looked like a really healthy option. So today what we're gonna do is we're going to look at Kathy Hanman's, and I'm sorry if I mispronounced your last name, but she sent in a recipe for a lemon chicken orzo soup. And it looks really good and actually relatively simple to make. So let's get going with that. All right, so first thing we got to know about this is I made the decision that it looks so good that I was actually going to double up on the recipe. So we're going to actually make twice as much of this as necessary. So this is twice as much as what I need for everything. And basically what it is, it's chicken. The recipe actually calls for chicken thighs, but I chose to go with chicken breast because you get more meat for less money and it was a good deal. You need carrots and celery stalks, two onions. It actually calls for two lemons, but they only had really little lemons at the grocery store, so I bought four little lemons. Some garlic, a couple of packages of orzo pasta, and some chicken broth. Now this was a little bit of a challenge because the recipe calls for 10 cups of chicken broth, but unfortunately, the chicken broth only is measured in ounces. So I had to do some kind of quick calculations in the grocery store. Fortunately, I had my cell phone, which told me that the basic conversion rate is 1 cup equals about 8 ounces. So since I need 10 cups, that's gonna be about 80 ounces. Each one's 32 ounces, so I got 96 ounces. So we're gonna have a little bit of leftover. You need some olive oil, some fresh parsley, some fresh rosemary. They actually called for dried thyme, but I couldn't find, well, I could have found dried thyme, but I always go fresh if I can. And then some bay leaves. So I am gonna add the recipe to the comment section or into the description section of this video. So if you're interested in trying this, check it out. Now, everything I'm gonna talk about here is based on the fact that I've doubled up on the recipe. So everything I'm gonna say is two times what you're gonna find if you just make a single batch of this. Now in her email, Kathy actually mentioned that she makes this a lot and her family really loves it. And just for a little variety, she'll mix it up a little bit with some of the veggies and some of the ingredients she'll put in. She'll sometimes say she'll include spinach. She'll sometimes substitute lime juice for lemon juice. A little hot sauce is, you know, never a bad thing. And other things like that. So that's always an option. You can mix it up a little bit and kind of get a little variety and kind of make it your own. But usually when I like to make these recipes the first time, I like to make them pretty pure and pretty consistent with what the recipe is, just so I know what my base is, because then I know what I'm working with and then we can mess around with it next time. So the first step is I gotta dice up this chicken here. And they recommend dicing it into about 1-inch slices. So I'm just gonna do that. This is just like what we were doing when we were making the mushroom soup a few months ago. Just nice big healthy chunks. So the next step, now that we've got our chicken cut up into little chunks here, is we need to brown this a little bit. They recommend using about a tablespoon of olive oil. They actually recommend you cook it in your stock pot, but I actually prefer to cook it in a skillet because it's a little hard to get into the stock pot and mix things up. So I'm going to alter the recipe a little bit here and do this. But basically you start off by putting a tablespoon of olive oil in it, let it heat up a little bit, and then we're going to pour the chicken in and we're going to cook it a little. Now it says you want to put a little salt and pepper on it. I'm going to try and keep this maybe a little at least sodium level low by keeping the salt under control. I am going to put some pepper into it, but I think what I'll do instead is I'm going to put the salt in at the end and kind of make it taste the way I want it to do. So let's do that. So we're going to turn on the stove at kind of a medium heat. And so, like I said, mine goes 1 to 10, so we're going to set it at 5, maybe a little bit closer to 6. And about a tablespoon of olive oil, a little bit more is okay if you need it. Wait for that to heat up a little bit. And then we're going to pour the chicken in. Like I said, if you want a little salt on it, you can put it on at this point. I'm just going to do some ground pepper. No such thing as too much ground pepper for me, so like I said, this is a lot of this to taste. It says generally it'll take 2 to 3 minutes to do it, but since there's a little bit more in here, I'm just gonna do it until it gets to right, kind of the right level. You want to kind of get it to the point where the meat is kind of a white color. And then we're just gonna pour this into a bowl for a little while just to let it sit, because we gotta do other things now in preparation for this. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna chop up the carrots, the celery, the onions, the garlic, and we're gonna add some thyme. And since I don't really have a whole lot of places to store stuff, I'm gonna store it in here. So they recommend putting in a little bit, another tablespoon or so of olive oil, just to kind of help with the cooking a little bit here, so we don't end up burning, so nothing sticks. So I'm just gonna kind of get that done ahead of time, so that when I chop up stuff in the food processor, it can just go right into the pot here. So since I'm not really a huge fan of chopping up onions, I'm gonna let the food processor do all the dirty work. And then I'm just gonna dump the onions right into the pot. And now I'm gonna continue on with the carrots and the celery. Now, the recipe actually calls for you to peel the carrots. I'm generally not a fan of that. I just usually put them in there whole. Just a preference thing. If you wanna do it, you can. And then once again, the carrots and the celery go right into the pot. Actually gonna use a rubber scraper now because we're pretty much done with the food processor, just to get everything out of there. Next, we're gonna put in our garlic. I love garlic. Now we're gonna start cooking this. Once again, on kind of a medium heat. Just kind of keeping it moving in here. And then after all the veggies kind of get soft, mixing in the thyme. And then whisk it for another about a minute. Next, we're gonna whisk in the chicken stock. Takes a second to get each of them ready. Then we're gonna mix in a cup of water and bring it to a boil. Once we get it up to a boil, we're gonna mix in the orzo, the chicken, and the rosemary. And then we're gonna let it simmer for 10 to 12 minutes. And I forgot I put in the bay leaves also. Sorry, I didn't catch that on camera, I screwed up. In the time when it was heating up, I've also prepared my lemon juice and my parsley. And after the 10 to 12 minutes of simmering, we'll mix that in. And then we're pretty much done. Salt and pepper to taste. right, now we're gonna mix in our lemon juice and our parsley. And then we are basically done. Add a little salt and pepper to taste. Then comes that all-important taste test. You know, I don't think it really needs any salt and pepper. I think it's good just the way it is. So I'm just gonna kinda let it sit for a little bit. Move it off the heat. So I gotta admit, I wasn't entirely sure what to expect from this. Everything seemed like a good, like almost a chicken soup, until we started getting into the lemon. I thought, oh, that might be interesting. Let's see what that does, but it's really good. Definitely recommend it. Like I said, I didn't put any salt or pepper in afterwards. I think it's good just the way it is. It just tastes really healthy. Oh yeah, and there's probably at least, you know, 9 to 12 meals in that. So yeah, we're gonna eat for a while. All right, so the final word on lemon chicken orzo soup. It was really good. I was actually not expecting it to be exactly what it was. I was kind of expecting it to be kind of a chicken soup kind of thing. And it really wasn't. It was more, it had a more of a lemon flavor to it, which really surprised me. It was really tasty. I think the only comment I have, and it was probably my own fault, is I would probably include a little bit more liquid in it. And I think probably the reason that became, because it became more like a, you know, more of almost a stew kind of consistency than a soup. And I think that's probably because I put a little too much of the orzo pasta in it. And it probably just sucked a little bit too much of the moisture out. So what I actually ended up doing is I had about half a box of the chicken broth, and I mixed that in with it, and I think that'll give it a more soupy consistency in the future. But it was really tasty, it was really filling, and a very satisfying meal. So great job, Kathy. Two thumbs up. I will definitely leave the link to the recipe in the description of this video. And if you want to try it. It was really good. So I think that is all that I have for today. Thank you as always for watching, and I will see you next time on Escaping the Mouse. Good night.